This week, people around New Orleans celebrated Thanksgiving, and the Saints wanted to make sure everyone enjoyed the holiday. Last week, several players, including Pierre Thomas, Lance Moore, Jamon Bushrod, and others, gave out turkeys and the fixins at the Dryads YMCA in Central City.
Now, what goes better with food than football in honor of the black and gold? WDSU put on our very own Saintsgiving. This is great stuff. Here's WDSU anchor Randy Russo with some of the unique creations.
Mm-hmm. Here in Southeast Louisiana, we like to add a little spice to our Thanksgiving feast, from fried turkeys to oyster dressing and pecan pie. But here at WDSU, we're not just adding spice, we're adding some Saints flair to our favorite foods, dubbing it Saintsgiving. WDSU Director Mark Drago created the centerpiece of our meal, the Dirty Bird.
A Saints fan wants to have a dirty bird from Atlanta, roasted and, you know, plucked and everything. And that's what I did. I went ahead and roasted this turkey up.
You plucked it too?
No, I didn't know that.
From turkey to chicken. And Jay Gallet went against the grain with his Jonathan Quesadillas.
Now, you might be saying quesadillas and Thanksgiving? Absolutely. Now, you may ask, well, is it stuffed with turkey? No. It's chicken. But it works. Well, I think I probably get points off because it's kind of a Mexican-themed dish, but it's going to taste fantastic.
For Rosa Flores, she says when it comes to cooking, she goes for her strength, creativity.
So I bought the rolls. I have to admit that I did not bake them. But I went for the creative angle for Saintsgiving. So if you take a very close look, you can see that my Darren Sproles rolls actually have little Darren Sproles on them.
And another creative element, these rolls are also black and gold. We also have the Tracy portobello mushroom salad.
I marinated my portobello mushrooms with balsamic vinaigrette on top of thyme and oregano, and then laid it over a nice bed of spring mixed lettuce along with tomatoes, feta cheese, and cucumbers.
It looks so fresh too.
I made it last night.
Very good salad, Randy. Very good.
So what you see here, these are our sidelines.
Here we have black beans and yellow rice, D-line dressing, and of course, mashed potatoes and gravy.
I'm doing a little tribute to the offensive line, the hardest working unit in the NFL. So we got Jerry Evans smashed potatoes, and we also have Charles Brown gravy.
But as for the desserts, they were delicious. But they were not flag-free. John A. Jackson got a penalty for bringing the wrong ingredients for her Lance s'mores.
I am not, you know, the most culinary person in the world. I'm a producer. I can't cook. So I bought the wrong size marshmallows, apparently, and chocolate. Thank you, Jay, and wrong chocolate.
For our other producer, Kelly Herring, she is the baking connoisseur.
Well, I have the pumpkin cheesecake with Jimmy Graham crust.
Yeah.
And then I also made a Meacham Peachum pie. And this right here is a Flordily cutout.
But it got tackled by the oven.
And Lisa Marie, although there's not a mishap here, this is your fourth try.
Fourth cake. I killed four cakes in the process of making my Mitch King cake. Thank you very much. So there we go. And the reason I chose him is because he looks a lot like my little brother.
But in the end, it was Lisa Marie's King cake and Jay's Quesadillas, which came out on top, winning fan favorite for best dishes. On your side, I'm Randy Russo, WDSU News.